Hi friends, Vinish Kaliga here from Team Kaliga for the market stats for the month of November 2021. It's a quick overview of the average selling in percentages for the month of November 2021. Before we start, Vinish Kaliga, do subscribe at Team Kaliga on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter and all social media platforms to get updated on the market stats and any new deals, or if you have any off-market sale or any private sale happening, we will be able to assist you on that. Thank you so much for watching my videos and helping more people to reach out. So here are the transactions of year on year from November to 2022 to 2021. We are up by 3.3% for the month of November, and seasonally adjusted from October to November, it has a decrease of 2.5%. And now when you see the average selling price, this is year on year. So if you ever have bought a home last November, your home is up by 21% this year in November of 2021. And seasonally adjusted from October to November. So someone who bought a home in October, the price now is up by 2.5% in November. That's the monthly jump. And New Year is coming, people are rushing to buy homes with low interest rate, as low as 1.15%. So these are the total number of new listings. The listings are down by 13% year on year. So less number of people are selling their home. And that's the reason we are, as a Toronto Real Estate Board, telling the government to increase the supply of homes, so that if you have more number of listings, more number of supplies to maintain the home prices, to make it affordable for first time home buyers. And these are the seasonally adjusted. So people are now rushing to 14% on a seasonally adjusted basis in the total number of new listings. And if you see the days in market, so last year, the November, it was 28 days in market to sell a home. Today is 18 days. And believe in GTA, it's 7 days, not even 18. So days in market year on year is from 19 to 13. Seasonally adjusted. Now, this is the brown line with seasonally adjusted, and that's what the sales is happening. So we see the sales happening is always overcoming the seasonally adjusted sales. So that's why you see the huge home price index going up from 400,000 in the 2011 to 1.1 million in 2021. So this is the home price index. If you look at some of the commercial stats, here is the commercial stats. So 27.5% is the leasing activity lowered because of pandemic, because of many people going out of business, of the huge lease which is coming up. Because of that's the reason of the average lease going up. If you see, $10 was the lease in 2020, and now it's 12.23 on the leasing side, and it's a jump in the leasing. And when you see the condominium sales now, a quick overview of that. So year on year, the sales are up by 10% for condominiums, and the new listings are down by 30%. So not many people are selling their condos, maybe not getting top dollars for the condominium. So they're still holding the condominiums, not selling. And sales to new listing is 24%. Days in market is almost the same for condominium. It takes 20 days around to sell a condominium. And these are the rental stats. Now, if you see the total number of rentals year on year has gone up by 15%. It's better on, and the new listings are down. And this is the average one bedroom rent. So it has gone up by 2.4%, not much significantly, from 2000 to 2060. Many of the condos are still vacant and empty. And that's the reason you don't see much jump in the condo prices. But good for people who are new immigrants coming to the country, still affordable for someone to rent a home. So this is the total number of new listings, down by 32%. Quick view on the other market stats. Now, this is the historic sales of Toronto Real Estate Board. In 1975, the average price was $22,000, and way in 2020, it's $929,000, and in 2021, it's crossed 1.1 million. So depending upon which year you bought your home, this is, feel happy, you are in money. And this is the graph that shows that. Vinish Kaliga from Team Kaliga. Thank you so much for watching my videos. Do subscribe me on Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook. And thank you so much for watching my videos.